So in previous video, discuss the de Broglie equation, and here that de Broglie equation is coincide with the Bohr's atomic model. And in this video, in exam point of view, how they can asking the problem about the de Broglie concept or de Broglie equation. Simple. Here we observe the one model of problem, that is the, here the problem is the, what will be the wavelength of ball of mass 0.1 kg moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second. Here the given question is the, problem is the, what will be the wavelength of a ball, moving ball mass 0.1 kg, that is the mass 0.1 kg moving with a velocity is the 10 meter per second. So here we should find out the wavelength. So wave length, that is the lambda, lambda can be find out. And mass of a ball will be given. Mass of a ball, m is will be given in problem, that is the 0.1 kg. And remaining is the velocity is also given. V is the 10 meter per second. Okay. So lambda will find out wavelength. Mass and velocity, m and v will be given. So here we are using the which type of formula, that is the de Broglie's. De Broglie's equation. What is that? Lambda is equals to h by m into v. Where lambda will be find out. M mass is given in problem. V velocity is also given in problem. But h is not given in problem, but we have to know the h. H is the Planck's constant. Its value is the 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joule into second. Joule into second. And in erg, minus 27 erg into second. But why here we using the only joules, means joules is the higher unit, that is the MKS method. Kg higher units, MKS. Meter is higher units, MKS. Mass is present in higher units. Velocity also present in higher unit. So Planck's constant is also taken as a higher unit, that is in joules. But here one joule value is equals to 1 kg meter square second to the power of minus 2. Means this joule is converted in kgs. In place of joule is the kg meter square second to the power of minus 2 into second. So here this second, 1 second will be get cancelled, remaining is the 6.625 10 power minus 34 kg meter square second to the power of minus 1. So that means Planck's constant is taken in a kg meter. So in some books Planck's constant is 6.626 is also given, but you don't worry about that. Here 6.625 or 6.626, both are nearly equal value. So here we are substitute that values. H is the Planck's constant, that value is the 6.625 into 10 power minus 34. Units are the, that is the kg meter power minus 2 second inverse. Remaining divided by in denominator mass, that is the 0.1 kg into velocity, that is the 10 meter per second. So kg, kg will get cancelled. So meter, 1 meter will get cancelled. And here 0.1, 10 will get cancelled. remaining is 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 meter per second. Meter per second. So this is the wavelength value. Here the wavelength value is how much? 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 meter per second. By using this formula, we should find out the wavelength. What is the wavelength of a given ball? Wavelength of a given ball. So these type of problems will be asking in the exam point of view. So we should solve the in this way. So this is about the de Broglie's concept or equation. Next, in this dual behavior of matter, by using the de Broglie concept, we should explain the electron like microparticle is having the wave nature, and Heisenberg uncertainty principle is also the scientist Heisenberg's. He is introduced the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. From that principle also we should say electron like microparticle will having the both particle and wave nature. Next our topic is the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. What is that principle? Simple. When electron like microparticles moving with the high velocities, it is impossible for exact determination of its momentum and their position at a time. What is that? Electron like microparticle moving with high velocities, we do not exact determine for that microparticle position and momentum at a time. Simply that is called as Heisenberg uncertainty principle. That means momentum and position we do not find out at a time. So momentum and position we do not find out at a time. Simply that is called as Heisenberg uncertainty principle. So in statement it is given as, it is impossible to determine, it is impossible to determine accurately and simultaneously, accurately and simultaneously the position and momentum of a particle in an atom. That is called as Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Means accurately and simultaneously position and momentum of a particle in an atom we do not determine accurately, exactly. It is called as a Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. So in mathematically, the Heisenberg uncertainty principle will be denoted as delta x into delta p greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. The mathematical representation of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle is delta x into delta p greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Delta x into delta p greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. So equation is the mathematical representation delta x into delta p greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. So where p is the momentum, already we have to know what is that momentum. P is the momentum. So that momentum is equals to mass into value. So p is equals to mass into value. M means mass of electron, that is the constant. V means velocity of electron, that will be changes. So delta p is equals to m, mass of electron is not changes, into v, velocity of electron will be changes. So delta v. So p means delta p is equals to m into delta v.
here y we do not written as a m, as a delta m means mass of electron will be constant. So we do not change it as delta m, it will be present in m. So p is equals to m into v, from this delta p is equals to m into delta v. So thus delta p will be substituted in this equation. What will we get? Delta x into, in place of delta p we should write the m into delta v, greater than or equal to, remaining is same, that is the h by 4 pi. It is also another model of, or another mathematical representation of Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Another way for the mathematical representation of Heisenberg uncertainty principle is delta x into m delta v greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Another representation is delta x into delta p greater than or equal to h by 4 pi, or delta x into m delta v greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. In this equation, where delta x is uncertainty in position, what is that?